get activated, let's get activated,
activated.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
Gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When the kick off the bomb, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack.
Whoa.
Familiar with the scrubber, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some rats.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gon' tackle your little man.
Get them.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go. Activated.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in and feel it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. Benji calling money my ringtone.
Hundreds.
Or blue, put her in a friend zone. She turned on more.
Ooh.
Take one for the team, I do that for my boy.
Bread, game.
Time ticking. I'ma give it all until the last minute. Set up the block just for my man, I bet we win it. Go hard or go home, it's survival of the fittest.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Activated.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go.
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated.
Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Texas, no weather to speak of, sun out, roof open, yes, yes, and yes, a great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction to the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D, as their guys will do battle with the Tennessee Titans. Here's the dangerous Tyreek Hill. And it takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. Carry now for the former Badger, Jonathan Taylor. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Second down, another run with Taylor. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. A yard tougher, third down and 9.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Play action now, Prescott. And going deep for Hill. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. Call that a gain of 38. A big march forward on the third down conversion. So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. First and 10, Taylor now. And past the 30 down to about the 27. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. This defense for the Titans, they were very good in the win last week against Jacksonville.
And I'm eager to see the game plan and trying to attack them this week, because when you take it away 4 times through interceptions, what do you do now when you go into a game? Do you decide you can't throw the ball? Do you try and run it more? Or do you tell your quarterback, make sure you see your guys open before you deliver?
13 yards and a first down, Cowboys. First down, they'll run on first down. Taylor. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Here's 2nd and 9. Prescott off play action. And he's gonna go down. He's sacked back at the 24. Jeffrey Simmons able to record his 5th sack of the season. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's 3rd and long. Off the play fake, Prescott. And that will be incomplete. Oh, he left that one in a bad spot, but fortunately it's just an incompletion and not picked to bring up 4th down. And Zuerlein's kick is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
He was solid on the field goal, but not as solid on the kickoff there. And that'll put him at the 40-yard line to start this drive. Thank you. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 40. Tannehill going to turn and give this to him. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity. And that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Play action. It's Tannehill. This will go to Henry out wide. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
On second down, here's Henry. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. And we were down on the field watching Henry warm up before the game. He's a big man. No wonder he breaks those tackles.
And you remember what I told you when we were watching? It's not all pads. Yeah. When you get him out of pads and just see him in a regular suit or an outfit, he is a huge human being and a lot faster than what people know. When he gets rolling, he's a lot to bring down.
And they've got it in the red zone now, down at about the 19. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. Tannehill now to throw. Caught on the right side by Jones. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. Try and run for it with Henry. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. So second and goal, and the big man Henry alone in the backfield. They give it to him running left. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
This Cowboy defense trying to hold him out of the end zone. They've run it to third and goal. Tannehill going to hand to Henry on the option. And Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. Only a yard there, so it brings up fourth and goal. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it. And I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
Off the option, here's Henry. And he's not going to get in. They stop him at the 1. The big back, Derrick Henry, held out of the end zone. And this Cowboy defense comes up with a goal line stand. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. As mentioned, this one of the hottest teams in the NFL, riding that winning streak into this one. But now playing here on Thursday night, do you think that this helps or hurts their momentum?
Well, ordinarily, I'd say it hurts the momentum because now you get that short week. But when a team's playing as well as they are, it actually allows them to down focus and only worry about themselves and less about their opponent. So when you're playing well, you just worry about the things you're doing well and let the opponent deal with that.
3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. To throw is Prescott. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
He punted 5 times in the win last week as this one's away. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going out offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went 4 and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Tannehill. Man open here is Jones. And he's got to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Now Tannehill, and he's got his receiver, that's Sammy Watkins, and he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size, but slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Fake the handoff. Now Tannehill. This will be caught by Brown. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. On 2nd down, it's Henry. 43 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
I remember watching Derrick Henry come out of Alabama and sitting with some scouts, and one of the debate points with him was, while at Bama, how often did he have to deal with contact near the line of scrimmage? They were so good up front that he often got to the second level pretty easily. I think he's starting to answer those questions with runs like that. He's a physical, physical guy.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great, great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
They're looking at a 2nd and 8 now from the 10. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Down. Watch out. Tannehill going to get this forward on the jet sweep. And he's going to score. The Titans have taken the lead. Now for the extra point, Daniel Carlson. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Hill is going to take it out of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. Here's 2nd and 10. Play fake. Here's Prescott. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd.
So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat, in every meeting with reporters. This week, he kind of said, I've had enough, and I don't.
And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Cowboys.
I think you can make a fair case for Tyreek Hill being the most explosive player in the NFL when he gets his hands on the football, and that was Exhibit A.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and the lead is now 10-7. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away.
Taking it about the 1.
And he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line. Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with a little under a minute to go, they may try and work their way into field goal range and try to tie up this ball game. Tannehill's throw complete there to Moore. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Tannehill. And that's caught left side by Mo Alie-Cox. Now Tennessee going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender.
ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Here's second and a yard. A shotgun snap for Tannehill. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Throwing again is Tannehill. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. He's going to keep this again, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. And this is good from 57. Bombs away right there. So we've hit halftime on Turkey Day here in Dallas. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
3 yards the gain there, second down. Now Tannehill. And that's going to be incomplete. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
Tannehill with a play fake to Henry. He'll throw instead. Complete to Jones. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A good pickup there, 21 yards. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Now a play fake, and it's Tannehill. Buying time to his left. Henry's got it out on the left side. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Two chunk plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10, down at the 31. 10th carry now for Derrick Henry.
now to this point.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Henry again on second down. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
Defense these past few downs, able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
The kick by Carlson is good, and they will take the lead at 13-10. Now, they don't get a touchdown here on the opening drive of the third quarter, but I think maybe you still say mission accomplished as they come away with the lead.
No, absolutely. You keep the pressure on, right? You go downfield, get some points up on the board, and hope that you've motivated your defense to take the field and hold that lead.
And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they find themselves down on the scoreboard following the field goal a moment ago.
And I think even though they trail in the game now, I would consider that a win for their defense. And that's probably what they're telling the offense when they get to the bench. Hey, the onus is on you guys now. Get back out there and get us the lead back.
Good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a 3-point game. Second and 10.
Mike, 55. Check, 55. Check.
On play action, Prescott. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
You know, you're following up on this head coach and the pressure that he is under. CD, I want to switch it to you because you've been on winning teams, but I know you've been in similar situations too where things just are not going well. How do you approach that as a player?
It's a tough approach, Brandon, because you actually have to do the opposite of what you would think. You know, in your mind, you're thinking, I redouble my efforts, I go harder. In a sense, you have to back off a little bit. You have to do a little bit less. Do what you're supposed to do, but don't take on the pressures of doing more and trying to do your teammates' jobs as well. If you do that, that's really going to lead you to more issues.
Now on third down, that pass knocked down in the backfield and incomplete.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
A first down carry for Henry. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory.
58 yards on the ground for him so far.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Second down, they go again with Henry. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to take this down to about the 17. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a second and one.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
Well, it's apparent the defense understands the situation. They have to keep them out of the end zone here. That's a great start by them. A loss on that play. Can they force them into a field goal attempt and still give their offense an opportunity?
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal.
Out of the gun, Tannehill. Touchdown! Julio Jones with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Titans are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. And he will be taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this third quarter. We're on to the fourth here on Thanksgiving Day. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a 2-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain, and it's second down. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And, wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one, because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, well, guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. It's the former Patriot, Devin McCourty. And the Titans are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice, because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well, protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A well-executed 22-yard gain. Now Tannehill with a little touch pass to his wideout. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
From the 27, Tannehill. A check down here for Henry. And out of bounds right around the 20. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. Well, no doubt here in the fourth quarter, this is a huge defensive series.
Hey, they can read the scoreboard. They realize if they give up a field goal here, this game might be out of reach. They understand the stakes and are playing accordingly.
The last run got a couple here, 2nd and 8. They'll fake it. Now Tannehill. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game. Instead, they're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
The Titans on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. They set up the screen for Henry. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. The kick by Carlson is good. And that will stretch the lead up to 13.
So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps when you're trying to salt one away in the fourth.
Well, the possibility of being beaten by 2 late touchdowns or at least sent to overtime does exist, but time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
Taken at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They run once more with Taylor. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down. Off the play fake, Prescott. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. Bud Dupree in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Desperation time. Prescott on 4th. And able to catch it, but he's out of bounds. And the throw took him beyond the sideline, and that's going to be a turnover on downs. So now with a little over 2 minutes to play, the road back gets very difficult.
Difficult, but still not impossible if they go ahead and play this thing out. Now the defense has to come up big. They've got to go for the strip of the football on each and every snap to try and give themselves a chance.
Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12. Yeah. backs of the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column.
Henry again on second down. 110 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
Yeah, the Titans are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on third and two.
The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Open man, Julio. Touchdown, Tennessee. Julio Jones. With his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season.
And the Titans are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter.
And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
This taken in at the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish. First down, Prescott. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
So, CD, you talk about this football team, some of the whispers and reports, the social media posts, they hint at a locker room that's splintered, badly splintered. There was talk earlier, some guys might walk away entirely, but that hasn't happened, however, at least to this point.
No, and sometimes some of that talk is just that, talk. I mean, guys often say, that's it, I'm out of here, and then they realize, I'm not ready to retire yet. What am I going to do now? And they're really ready to come back and dive back in. In fact, we got guys who are wearing gold jackets in the Hall of Fame that talked about retirement the last 6-7 years of their career. So that's not always real. And sometimes you just have to go ahead and ride it out. And this is an opportunity now for everyone in this locker room to move forward.
On third down, it's Prescott. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Titans, they've got the football back, and they've got it in great field position. On first down, Henry. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. The Titans go victory formation down to a knee. So this one, a Tennessee Titan victory, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in